So we're starting the morning off a little later than we expected because Garmin adjusted my clocks back to central time, even though we're still in the eastern zone. We had a long day of paddling today. A lot of it flat water. Just a couple of runs in white water. Hopefully nothing too big. And we're hoping to beat the rain today. Today and tomorrow are two big rain days that we can see so far. This is going back on the first portage of the day. Straight down an island between two rapids. Definitely unrunnable. All right, while Mike is getting himself ready for whitewater, we're taking a look at the east side of the island. You can see that's just not something you're gonna run. We're talking about 4 or 5 foot waves from trough to crest. It's beautiful though. And this is the other side, which is the falls. And on the map, it is aptly labeled with a skull and crossbones because you're not surviving the ride through those. Beautiful. This is our second portage of the day. Portaging around what I would consider a class 3 because it requires some careful maneuvering, and it has waves that are more than 3 feet tall. Pretty intense wave terrain. It is runnable. What's the name of this lake, Mike? It's not termite anymore.
Not a lake named no name
around here. And our rain is kind of holding off. So what you're looking at here is a burn that happened in 2015. And you can see the forest is returning. It was pretty well burned down, you can tell. And this is something you could see in the boundary waters now.
Well, we are riding out a pretty good rainstorm, some wind, in the middle of Brennan Lake. Got off just before it really started coming down.
We're on Brennan Lake. We're taking a shortcut. And it's a nice shortcut. A little current pushing us through a little faster, and beautiful little canyon-like situation. Just above Brennan Falls. It's pretty tight in here, but we had some nice drops, some class ones dropped us in here.
So we got an issue here. This is the northern route, supposedly the safer route to avoid Brennan Falls. These two creeks, or two pieces of the stream, come together, and this portage came right down the middle, but right now it's just kind of running through the forest, and we're gonna have to walk out over those rocks, I guess. And we walked it down. Bob took a spill, but he's okay, and all that just to go right there.
stupid morning on day three. This was supposed to be our 100% chance of rain day. As you can see, we're looking at bluebird skies.
Little breakfast spread this morning. Little pancake, some bacon, and compulsory hot coffee.
Good morning, Mike.
Morning.
And it's actually nearly noon. But we had a beautiful sight. And we're ready to leave that behind us and hit some more rapids. There's our portage, and that's what we're portaging around.
The top of Granite Falls.
We can get a better picture of it just sliding into that one.
On the Allanwater River. crazy.
It starts out pretty tranquil, still moving pretty good. Then as we get on here, it starts to have 4 foot high waves. And then, we run into that kind of turbulence. Same rapid from the bottom. This is a class one that leads into the start of Little Sturgeon Rapids, which we're gonna run this first section. Thank you.
Now you're going to put me out into it. Again, because you're out in the current, I'm going to let you swing out that way when we head out.
Sturgeon Rapids. We did not run this one. We did run little sturgeon. All of it, pretty much. Yeah, we did. And this ends Allanwater River.